Hey again, it's Jason from Fraser Valley Rose Farm, and recently I've been geeking out by going through a bunch of plant ID apps for my Android phone and seeing which ones do really well identifying plants and which ones don't do so well at all. I thought I'd share those results with you today. It's not exactly the right time of year to go shooting flowers in bloom in the field in my climate, so I had some images saved on my phone that I used as test subjects on these different apps. The plants that I had in these images, I wanted to see how close it came for genus and species. So I had Rudbeckia subhortella, Eryngium giganteum, Asclepias incarnata, and Cornus kousa, and I wanted to see how well the apps came up with those genus and species and scored them accordingly. The first of the apps I'm going to talk about here is the only one that I will not recommend, so I'll get this one out of the way right away. It's an app that was called Plant Lens, and it had a relatively low rating on the Android store, but it was right at the top of the sponsored list, so I thought I'd give it a try. It had a rating of 3.5. I downloaded it, and I have to say, first of all, that it hits you up right away with all sorts of screens trying to get you to sign up for a subscription. Its subscription is relatively expensive. It comes out to about $144 a year. After some maneuvering and gymnastics, I was able to get through to a screen where I could try out the plant ID, and the results were awful. It only got 1 out of 4 of the different pictures correct, and kept on hitting me with ads and splash screens trying to get me to sign up for the app. So this one is in the category of truly awful, and I wouldn't recommend it, so I'll move right on to my next one. The next one I tried was another one that's done by the subscription model. It's called Picture This, and the subscription on this one is only about $30 a year, so big difference in the prices there. It also offers a fairly hassle-free 7-day free trial. So I signed up for that right away and had a look at how it did on the plants, and remarkably better. It was up to an 88%, which means it got all of the genus right and just one of the species it didn't get correct in my trial of these 4 test plants that I had. I will also say that with that subscription, it looks like it has some other neat features that either allow you to connect with the community or share your images or learn more about plants as you're going along. So I thought it was probably a fairly good value proposition, and again, only about $30 a year. The third one I tried really surprised me. It was called PlantNet, and it was it scored really well in the App Store, a 4.5 in terms of its overall approval rating. And so I wanted to see what this was about, and actually it was outstanding. This one is completely free, doesn't run ads, so it's a community-supported project of education and research. So it's a public enterprise, and what I found when I tested it on the different plants is it was extremely accurate. Now, one thing I will say about PlantNet is that it was a little confusing in terms of its screens. If you go onto the app, it's going to ask you, first of all, to choose a flora group that you're asking for. I chose World Flora because it was the largest, and it gave me really, really good results. But there's also ones where you can choose the flora of South America, the flora of Canada, useful plants, and so on. And I think that your results may vary depending on which database you sign up for. The second thing it does is, as you choose the picture, if you close up on, for instance, Cornus kousa was one of my subjects, you may say berries instead of flowers. So it asks you to specify between flowers, bark, berries, or other features, and that, I assume, will help it to ID correctly the picture. It wasn't too much of a hassle, but it's something different than the other apps, so I thought I'd point it out here. Overall, it had really, really good accurate results, and I had a lot of fun afterwards going out to the field and trying some winter plant ID with it, so I'll tell you about that in a minute. The fourth one I tried was called Leafsnap. Now, Leafsnap is different in that it is ad-supported. So every time you do a plant ID, it's going to ask you to watch an ad for 30 seconds or a skippable ad, which is no big deal, I guess. If it has good results, that seems like a fair proposition to me as compared to the subscription model. I guess maybe not as nice as PlantNet, which was free, but also fairly good. One thing I did note about it, though, and it had good results and good ratings, is that it seemed to follow the PlantNet IDs almost exactly. It asks the same questions, whether to go for flower or bark or fruit, and then it gives the same answers. It almost seemed like it was just using the database of PlantNet and then inserting ads to make some money off of it. I don't know if this is true or not, but I can't recommend it from the point of view of it's giving me the exact same results as a free, public-supported or community-supported piece of software, and it makes me watch ads in the meantime. So I would probably go back to PlantNet as my recommendation because the results were just as good and you don't have to watch the ads. After testing the apps on those four initial images I had saved on my phone, I thought I'd go out and have some fun trying them on winter landscape plants and see how they did. And I have to say, the one that stood out was PlantNet. I mean, once I picked the world flora category, it had no problem getting close to 100% ID on everything that I showed it. Once I keyed in, either it was the fruit or the flower or the bark. One that I chose to look at was one called Acer grisium, or the paper bark maple. And that one has coppery colored bark as well as a distinctive peeling bark. And once I told it was the bark it was looking at, PlantNet had no problem identifying it. It also had a great time picking out anything that was flowering this time of year. My hellebores it had no trouble with. The mahonia that was in the landscape it had no problem with. Sweet box it did straight away. So it did a great job. It was a lot of fun. So I have a feeling I'm going to keep this on my phone because it's free, because it's ads, not no ads to watch anything else. There's no downside to this app at all. So I'm going to keep it on my phone. I would say the other ones were all worthwhile for the time that I tried them, with the exception of that plant lens, which was just garbage, and I wouldn't even keep it on my phone for one day. All right, that's it for the Plant ID apps. I hope you enjoyed, and if you have any questions for me, or even Plant ID questions, let me know in the comments below the video, and thank you for watching.